Retailers across the world, and there are 19 countries which is explored and spread, Asian Pune spread to. Moving to the next slide.
Video. So guys, I think I have promised you a video, so just look at it.
जा बरकत जा, ये लड़का मेरी शादी किसी और से होने नहीं देगा।
थैंक यू पापा।
ताबर तोड़ तू बादल भोड़ तू बाबूल छोड़ तुम्हारी बरकत दुआ।
वाटरप्रूफिंग वाला एक्सटीरियर पेंट, एशियन पेंट्स अल्टिमा प्रोटेक्ट। बारिश को आने दो।
Next.
This video shows nothing but the quality of the paints, of course. Over to you. So the main objectives of the Asian paint was obviously the common objective that every company has is to become the world's largest in its proper market and proper economy. The next one is to form the new business strategy and to become the main productive marketing company in the manufacturing markets of the industries. Basically, the Indian industries, of course.
Next slide, please. Next slide. So major challenges faced during 1945 to 1952, as you can see, due to lack of infrastructure and transportation system, there was disruption in distribution channel. Next was margin. Why would a rural people buy high quality product but with high price? No, they don't want to buy high price product. Why would they buy? So the major challenge was to provide high quality product with low price. Next was marketing. So now we enjoy social media and other advertisement medias to advertise ourselves, our products. But that was the time when there was no marketing media or platform. So this was one of the most important, or to say challenge, major challenge faced. Next was lack of knowledge. That was the era of high illiteracy rate. People were not aware about new products and new things coming in the market. Why would they use? They have own traditional ways of using tuna for their cattle houses. Why would they use paints? So this was also one of the major challenges. Now let's see the solution for it.
So you guys might be wondering, with so much of challenges, how could they survive in such a big paint market with the competitors like Nerolac and Berger Paints? So as you know that Harkar Jeetne Wale Ko Bhi Bazigar Kehte Hai, Richampak Lal Choksi was one of those guys. So he thought that the four A's, that is acceptance, affordability, availability and awareness, will make a big difference. First of all, he thought to penetrate into rural markets. As my partner told you, that in the starting of the Quit India movement, the other paint industries was mainly focusing on the urban areas. It was the easiest option. But the Asian paints focused on the rural market. They start penetrating in the rural market with the great idea. They first painted the Mukhiya's house with the washable paints 6 months prior before their promoting the paints. Next was affordability. The rural area guys face main problems with the costing and the afford, and they can't afford the big the costable things. So he mainly focuses on the affordability things. So the paints which was first in the market was the washable paints, which was of low quality, and the plastic emulsions, which was of higher cost. So he made the washable emulsion paintings, which was of the great quality and the lowest price that he can give. Next was availability. One of the example I would like to tell you, that the bull festival in Tamil Nadu, it's Pongal, and in Maharashtra it's Pola. So the bull horns are being painted with the help of this washable paints, and they used to come off very quickly. So these washable paints that was made by the Asian paints was so durable that the people started using it, and that was the quick thing that Champaklal Choksi focused on. Next was the awareness. Due to this thing, the people started to get aware about these paints and started using it. Next slide, please.
As said by my partner, there is a proverb, garib apne ghar ko rangi na rangi par apni dehli zarur rangta hai. So moving towards the market size and market share, market size is estimated to be 50,000 crore. Moving towards the share, Asian Paint own 30% of the share, kyunki har ghar kuch kehta hai. Narrow Lake, which owns 20%. Next is Empirical Chemical Industries, 12%. Berger Paints, 19%. Others, 19%. Next slide, please.
So the current marketing strategy basically divided into product strategy, pricing strategy, distribution strategy. So the product strategy was like they were immensely emerging with a lot of different idea about the paints. The first range of the Asian paint was the Utsav range. The next was the Wall Putty range. And now, as you all know, the Imperial range and the Royal Blue range. So this was the some of their products which is shown over here.
As you can see, one of the product here.
Yeah, I am walking, talking Asian paint catalog myself today. Yeah, next.
Next slide. Pricing.
Pricing, it's the premium targeted, which was high rated. It's almost the, they prepare their paints in the smaller container so that the people could use it first and then get the taste of it and use it as long as they want. Next slide, please. Yeah, this was a promotional strategy of theirs. Anybody of you know about Gattu? Yeah, he was the character which was painted by R.K. Lakshman. So Asian Paints use him as this a strategy for the promotional market. Har Ghar Kuch Kehta Hai is one of those first promotional strategies given by the Asian Paints. Next
slide.
Yeah, he's the Gattu. Yeah, Bollywood campaigning is the common thing which is happening in the market. So the first brand ambassador was Saif Ali Khan. Next one was Ranbir Kapoor and second was Deepika.
Next slide. Talking about the revenue, from 2019, the revenue was 6,230 crores, which increased to 19,641 crores in 2018. Next slide, please. Competitive analysis between Asian Paints versus Narrowlake. Net sale of Narrowlake was 1,141.98 crores, whereas Asian Paint was 4,235 crores.
The other values. Next slide, please. Yeah, so conclusion is the Asian Paints have captured rural market. Rural India is unique in its own way, so we have to explore it yourself. Thank you so much.
Thank you.